This has been a rapidly intensifying storm, and so now it reached the top of that Saffir-Simpson scale. So it is a Category 5 hurricane as it's making its way through the Gulf of Mexico. Taking a look at it here on our radar here, you see it's still spinning and it's moving towards the Gulf-facing areas of Florida. But let's take a closer look here at Hurricane Milton. You see how well-defined this eye is. It's a really small, tight spin there. And so the tighter the spin, the stronger the storm. Think of an ice skater, and the closer they are, the faster they spin. So this is a really strong storm headed towards Florida. Now it is forecasted to decrease in intensity due to some shear in the atmosphere right before it makes its way to landfall, but still forecasted to make landfall in the Tampa area on that Gulf facing side and as a Category 3 hurricane. So still a major hurricane is forecasted to land and make landfall in Florida. Now the Tampa area, Fort Myers area, that is an area that we really want to keep in mind of and keep our thoughts over, because the quadrants of a hurricane is really important when it comes to the impact. So the right front quadrant of a hurricane, that's where you have the highest risk for strong wind, tornado, surge, and flooding, even in the right rear. And think of that, you have that spin, that counterclockwise spin of the actual storm, as well as the movement of the storm. So that's a lot of force moving that way. So of course, our thoughts is going to be in Florida over the coming week.